Hello, I'm Kairano from Physiology Department, School of Medical Sciences, University Science Mission. In this video, we are going to talk about hypoxemia, hypoxia, hypocapnia, and hypercapnia. Hypoxemia is the reduction in the arterial pressure of oxygen to less than 60 mm mercury, or reduction of oxygen saturation in the arterial blood to less than 90%. Hypoxemia may cause hypoxia, which is decrease in oxygen delivery to the tissues, or decrease in oxygen utilization by the tissues. However, hypoxia may also be caused by other factors than hypoxemia. Hypoxemia has multiple causes, whereby the causes can be compared using AA gradient or AA difference. AA gradient is the difference between the alveolar pressure of oxygen and the arterial pressure of oxygen. Normally, oxygen pressure equilibrates across the alveolar or pulmonary capillary barrier, and the AA gradient is close to zero. In some cases of hypoxemia, the AA gradient can be increased. This occurs when the alveolar pressure of oxygen is higher than the arterial pressure. This can occur in diffusion defects. For example, in fibrosis or pulmonary edema, there is increase in diffusion distance or decreased surface area for diffusion. So, alveolar pressure of oxygen cannot equilibrate with the arterial. AA gradient is increased, hence may cause hypoxemia. Increase in AA gradient may also occur in VQ mismatch or in right to left shunt. In some cases of hypoxemia, the AA gradient can be normal. The alveolar pressure of oxygen equilibrates with the arterial pressure. This can occur in high altitude. At high altitude, the barometric pressure is decreased, which decreases the pressure of oxygen in inspired air and of the alveolar air. Equilibration across the alveolar capillary barrier is normal, so the arterial blood achieves the same reduced pressure of oxygen. Another example is hypoventilation. Hypoventilation decreases alveolar pressure of oxygen. Equilibration across the alveolar capillary barrier is normal, so the arterial blood achieves the same reduced pressure of oxygen. Hypoxia is decrease in oxygen delivery to the tissues, or decrease in oxygen utilization by the tissues. There are three mechanisms of tissue hypoxia. 1. Inadequate oxygenation of arterial blood, which can result in reduced arterial pressure of oxygen. 2. Inadequate systemic oxygen transport. This can be caused by decreased cardiac output or decrease in hemoglobin or red blood cells, or if there is local obstruction in the blood vessel. 3. Is inadequate peripheral oxygen utilization. This is means that there is impairment in oxygen utilization by the tissues. Hypoxia can be divided into 4 categories based on the underlying mechanisms. Hypoxic hypoxia, which is hypoxemia, reduced in arterial pressure of oxygen. As mentioned earlier, it can be caused by high altitude, diffusion defects, VQ mismatch, or hypoventilation. Anemic hypoxia is characterized by normal arterial pressure of oxygen, but low total oxygen content of arterial blood. It can be due to inadequate numbers of erythrocytes, hemoglobin, or competition for the hemoglobin molecule by other compounds such as carbon monoxide. The probable causes are blood loss, anemia, or carbon monoxide poisoning. Stagnant or ischemic hypoxia, are also sometimes known as hypoperfusion hypoxia, is the reduction in blood flow to the tissues. The arterial pressure of oxygen is normal. Total oxygen content is normal, but little oxygen in the blood reaches the tissues. This may be caused by heart failure, which is whole body hypoxia, shock, which is peripheral hypoxia, or thrombosis, which is hypoxia in a single organ. In histotoxic hypoxia, the amount of oxygen delivered to a tissue is adequate, but the tissue cell cannot make use of the oxygen because the cells have been poisoned. The most common cause is cyanide poisoning. Cyanide blocks cytochrome oxidase and other cellular enzymes essential for internal respiration. When arterial pressure of carbon dioxide is decreased below that normal, it is termed hypocapnia. On the other hand, if it is increased above than normal, it is termed hypercapnia. Hypocapnia is when arterial pressure of carbon dioxide is lower than 40 mm mercury. It can be caused by hyperventilation. When ventilation increases, arterial pressure of oxygen increases, while carbon dioxide decreases, hence termed hypocapnia. Hypercapnia is when arterial pressure of carbon dioxide is higher than 45 mm mercury. It can be caused by hypoventilation. When ventilation decreases, arterial pressure of oxygen decreases, while carbon dioxide increases, hence the term hypercapnia. So I hope you enjoyed this video. Thank you for watching.